my name is Necail McNeil, and basically I had a daughter 2 years ago in August, and she was 2 months premature. I had her from being sick with food poisoning. I was sick with food poisoning for about 14 hours before my water broke, and set me into premature later, of course. And so, yeah, I was 32.2 weeks gestational period, so 2 months premature. And I was lucky too, because I found out I was having a girl, so I was a little more prepared in that sort of sense, which was kind of good. And, you know, she, first thing is they said, oh, we don't have beds for her here in the hospital here. She may have to go one to Seattle, one to Calgary. Thank God that they found a bed in Vancouver. So I hadn't even held my daughter yet, and they flew her to Vancouver Children's Hospital, and she spent 48 hours there. So she came back 48 hours later, and I finally got to hold her, but she, you know, she's in the incubator and everything. She was 4 pounds, 9 ounces, which was pretty big for a premature 2-month-old baby. So we were lucky in that sense too. And you know, she came back to the special care nursery here in Victoria, and everyone was great there, except for this one nurse said, if you want to get your baby home quicker, get her on the bottle. So that frustrated me, and luckily I met another nurse there that was just, you know, passing through and helping another girl, and I just kind of, you know, was listening to what she was saying to her, helping her to get her on the breast and everything. And I said to her, you know, I'd really like for you to come over and help me too, if I could and stuff, because I didn't know what to do, who to get support from. All I had was this older nurse saying, if you want to get your baby back, you know, home quicker, get her on the bottle. Very frustrating. I came from a mother who we adopted my brother when he was 2 weeks old, and she ended up breastfeeding him through the tube and everything like that. So I know there is success stories, and, you know, sure, my mom's there to help, but, you know, she can't be there all the time and everything, and I'm at the hospital 24/7. So this nurse's name was Mary, thank God. She had twins premature too, so she went through the same experiences as me. And she helped me just to get latched on and everything, and say, it was great. She says, oh, she's a natural, she can do it. And you know, it was just great encouragement and everything for that too. So I really, you know, I would love to thank her now and everything. And if I could find her, I have no idea where she is or anything. But Mary from Victoria General, if you're out there, thank you very much. And so she got it going, and, you know, I just kept pursuing it. And, you know, when I got another lactation specialist to help me once in a while too. But then, you know, her weight wasn't coming up, and, you know, it's still the nurses saying, get her on the bottle and everything. You know, they did the tube feeding. I think that last about a week and a half before she got out of the hospital, because she was just nursing all the time, and, you know, I wasn't even in the hospital with her, I was back at home. Thank God I only lived about 10 minutes away. And so I just rushed home for every feeding and stuff like that too. So, you know, we just persevered and did it, and got some great support from, you know, I didn't see that there was any great support out there, but I just kind of lucked into it and found the great support. And then, you know, because she was so small and her mouth is so small, I kept getting cracked nipples and everything too. So, you know, I was bawling because my nipples were bleeding. And I finally went to a lactation specialist doctor here in town, and she taught me how to get her on properly and exercises to do with her to open her mouth properly to grab on, because she was just damaging my nipple. And I was all about ready to give up again. This is probably about 2 to 3 months after I got in her home and stuff, because we've been constantly just doing that, right? And so, yeah, thank God for that. And then we did the nipple shield and everything too. So, and then she said, just take a break. Pump it and bottle feed her for, I think it was like 4 days or something like that, just to get the healing process back. And you know what? It was like night and day after that.